If you're using fish oil like most people, you're probably missing out on your potential. I'll show you how to fix that with three quick tips for how to use fish oil for muscle growth, recovery, pretty much anything, based on my own lab research and one really embarrassing experience with tactical athletes. So let's jump right in. I'm David Barr, and if you're looking to get bigger, faster, stronger, get leaner, go longer, hit that subscribe button to make sure you don't miss anything. So why would we use this stuff? And it comes down to muscle protein synthesis, among other things. That's the muscle growth recovery adaptation response that we typically want. And this is related to some of the research I conducted. We started to find in the lab that people had different sensitivities to protein synthesis and the stimuli that caused that. So we call this anabolic sensitivity, or in the case of one of the projects we saw in the elderly, they had what's called anabolic resistance. So they didn't respond very well to anabolic stimuli. Now, one of the cool parts is that I read a study about fish oil in elderly enhancing the protein synthetic response. They became more anabolically sensitive. Now, the inner meathead in me kind of freaked out, got all excited, wanted to extrapolate this to my athletes, clients, and of course myself. So I contacted the lead researcher. She got back to me right away and said, yeah, it's very exciting. But the other cool part is that we've also studied this in healthy adults and we get the same effect. That is the increase in the anabolic sensitivity. So this is very exciting. This is why we would want to use fish oil. Again, the enhanced muscle growth, recovery, adaptation response. Now, more recently, one of my mentors in the protein synthesis lab, Dr. Kevin Tipton, conducted some research on fish oil and anabolic sensitivity, and they found that there was actually no increase. So I'm not exactly sure what's going on here. I will be very interested to see if we can figure out what the differences are. I will be firsthand invested in that, so stay tuned. But right now, fish oil seems like a great bet for athletes, muscle growth, that kind of thing. So for fish oil side effects, not really anything we need to worry about, but there was a brutal experience I had giving my first ever talk for the NSCA. It was at a tactical strength conditioning symposium. So that's like fire, police, military, that kind of thing. And I was treating them like athletes. I was so naive. So just kind of casually threw out fish oil. Yeah, you should be using fish oil, but it might extend clotting time, might make you bleed a little longer. At the time, it was a small concern, but now we know it's not a big deal in healthy humans. But I wasn't dealing with just normal humans, right? Not just dealing with regular athletes. So a hand shoots up in the crowd and asks, like, so Dave, we shouldn't be using fish oil if it's going to make us bleed out? And I felt like an ass because, like I said, I was treating them like athletes. These people are not worried about medals or prize money. They're putting their lives on the line and they could conceivably die if they get shot, if they bleed out. So great lesson there, definitely. But for tactical athletes, they should take it on a case-by-case basis. For most other healthy people, don't need to worry about the bleeding effect. But as always, get your advice from your medical professional. Now, real quick, if you're using fish oil, what kind of dosing and timing protocol are you using? Just let us know in the comments below. So one of the most surprising knowledge bombs that I drop on people is related to fish oil dosing, and I'm actually a little surprised that it's surprising to people, so meta surprise, which is great. As long as it's helping people, then it's important to get that info out there. Specifically with regard to fish oil dosing, most people will want 1 to 3 grams of fish oil a day. So if each cap is a gram, then people will take 1 to 3 caps a day. But that's not accurate because that's not actually what you're after. You're after two key fats within the fish oil capsule. These are called EPA and DHA, and they make up about 36% of the total oil in the cap. So if you're looking to get a gram of these fats a day, then you're going to want to triple the current dose of, say, 1 cap a day. So I myself take, you know, 4 caps a day, roughly 1.5 grams of these key fats. But look on the back of your fish oil bottle and you will see the actual amount of EPA and DHA, and that's what you're after. So often, you know, 3, 4+ caps is what people are after. Apparently this changes lives and blows minds, which is fantastic. So hopefully this is one of those things that helps you. Quick tip about fish oil timing. Timing of day really doesn't matter. It's more about the timing of your food. So you want to consume your fish oil with with a meal, particularly a fat-containing meal, because the body loves to burn through fish oil. The oils are very, very sensitive, and the body wants to oxidize the hell out of them. We don't want that. That kind of defeats the purpose. So just consume your fish oil caps with a meal, with a fat-containing meal. As far as who should use fish oil, well, it's almost easier to list the people who wouldn't want to use fish oil because pretty much everyone can use it. Obviously, if we're after the growth and recovery response, then any athlete, any strength, power, endurance athlete can use this. Certainly for bodybuilding, muscle growth, recovery, adaptation. I mean, just overall, fish oil is a great addition to your supplement regimen. So here's your three-step checklist that you can use to see if you want to add fish oil to your supplement regimen. Check number one is going to be testing for banned substances and purity. And yeah, you can find fish oil out there that has those. This is especially important for athletes. Number two is going to be how long has this stuff been around, and fish oil has been around forever. Doesn't mean it's rock solid proof that it's going to be efficacious or effective, but it's a good clue because most ingredients come and go. They only last for a year or two and then they're gone. So that's why we've had thousands of ingredients come and go, but fish oil seems like a good bet. Check number three is going to be the big one. It's proof, and more specifically proof on PubMed. Do we have actual evidence of efficacy on PubMed that fish oil is going to do what we want it to do? And yeah, we do. We talked about this, it may be equivocal. It may show, may go both ways, but like I said, we'll keep an eye on that. I'll keep you apprised, updated on things. But so far, proof looks positive. So there's your three-step checklist. Now you decide. Hey, thanks for watching. If you like this video, be sure to check out the rest of the channel. And don't forget to hit that subscribe. Don't miss anything. Until next time, raise the bar.